Ivy, Zachy. No questions?
All right, thank you.
Thank you. Merry Christmas, guys.
Ryan, yeah. Just for whoever wants it, what did you guys take from this game, I guess?
You talking to me?
Whoever wants it.
Try again, go ahead. What did you take from it?
You got it.
He asked.
He was looking at me, so I thought.
All right, man. I mean, obviously, we wanted to use this as a kind of like a confidence game. We didn't shoot as well, but we did some good things. We know we want to get to zone pretty much all game, and that's something we got to put more work into. As you know, people will go more zone as we go on with the season. It was good to kind of see that tonight and kind of see where we can improve. So.
Zach, to dominate the rebounding like you guys did, did you guys reach the rebounding level that you wanted to in this game?
It's always our goal to dominate the glass, especially when we play a team like that doesn't really have the size or strength to keep us off the glass. So it's just kind of like, it's always our goal to try to do what we did today, but we obviously, it's tougher to do that against different opponents. But yeah, we dominated the glass, so that was always a our goal is always to have less turnovers and more rebounds to the team, and we have more rebounds today.
For Zach, Matt said a bunch of times now that the biggest thing you've improved from one year to the next was your passing. How did you go about doing that? Is that just experience, or is that something you can actually practice? How does that work?
I think it's both. It's something we definitely practice and we go through in practice like we do. We'll always have those three spots on the other side that we pass to in the practice. But it also comes with experience. Like when I first came in, I didn't really get post touches at my high school. So like learning to get post touches, learning how to score the post touches, but also learning when to pass when you're facing a double was something that I had to learn when I first came here. So it's just experience and practice as well.
Jaden, you guys are, you know, going to get a break here for Christmas and all that kind of stuff, but just you guys seem to be playing pretty well. I mean, is this a team that needs a break and needs to kind of reset itself a little bit, or you feel like you guys
honestly,
are in pretty
good
shape?
I don't like breaks. I'm always at it, you know, 24/7. You know, I love the game, and you know, obviously we have a break and we're looking forward to it, but you know, I personally don't like the break. So but you know, I'm just, you know, gonna enjoy this win, and you know, obviously I get to, you know, see my family. And it's been a while since I've, you know, been at my home. And I get to see my little dog. So I'm just looking forward to that. And, you know, when we get back, you know, it's business.
What's it do to your offensive approach, Jaden, when you know these guys are going to get most of the offensive rebounds? What does it do to your approach offensively when you know you have these two guys and they're getting damn near every offensive rebound?
It means, you know, we get the, you know, offensive rebound, you know, we – you know, either, you know, kickouts for threes. You know, if I don't have some, you know, I kick to, you know, the shooters, and you know, but when we get defensive rebounds, that, you know, that's just an opportunity, you know, to get out in transition. And you know, if I don't have some, playoff two, and you know, look for my teammates.
Trey, this seems like an appropriate time to ask, why did you start wearing the headband?
Oh man.
You like them with the head.
They suggested the headband, you know, because I switched up the hairstyle. I had the fro rocking for a little bit, and then I came twisties. It's a little nappy right now, sorry. But just ever since I kind of changed my hairstyle, Coach Painter has never let anyone wear a headband. He said the rule for that was to get 20 rebounds in a game, and obviously that's something I did against Michigan when I had 36 and 20. So I'm just using it to my advantage, man, and you know, thank God everybody's, you know, rocking with it. So,
why did you guys want him to wear a headband?
Just feel like he plays better with a headband. See, it's him, I guess. Mm-hmm.
Headband hero.
Hey, Jaden, what steps did you see this team take defensively against Butler that you perhaps carried into tonight?
I think just the intensity. You know, we just brought the force, and we felt like, you know, we brought the energy, you know, from the beginning to the end. And, you know, that's what you need. You just need to, you know, bring that presence on defense and, you know, just take teams out of their stuff.
Trey, when you guys come back from break, I mean, what do you want to see out of your group as you get into practice and then jumping back into Big Ten season?
Man, I actually was just, you know, talking to the guys in the locker room, and you know, you can kind of tell and you can kind of see it that, you know, everybody needs a break, or everybody deserves a break to be with family. You know, obviously everybody will do their own, like, individual stuff, you know, when they're at home, whether it's workouts, just going to shoot. So, you know, that part of it doesn't stop. But as far as games, you know, I think everybody needs a break. You know, we've been on the road, you know, traveling and, you know, just going from place to place. There's been a lot going on. School, man, so I think this break is going to be very useful. But, you know, like Jaden said, when we get back, man.
School, man.
When we get back, man, it's all business. And, you know, guys know what to expect. And, you know, we'll be walking into a Big Ten play. So we got to come with it.
Kind of your quick thoughts on what you saw tonight, and how is this going to carry over into when you're back at it again after this break?
Well, I thought we had a good focus the other night against Butler. Obviously, when you play that quick turnaround, you have one day to practice. You're getting ready to go on break. Sometimes things can get a little sticky. I thought our guys were good. I thought we missed some shots against that 1-3-1 that were pretty good shots. We really could have pushed the lead at that time. I thought, you know, this. I think this was their best shooting game. Incarnate Word. They really stretched us out, and you know, our closeouts weren't great from the guards. They picked on us a little bit with our size and tried to drag us out a little bit. But you know, I thought we did some good things. Obviously, rebounding the basketball, we did a good job rebounding the basketball. You know, we had the same amount of turnovers, 11 as Incarnate Word had. But I thought we did a good job. When you sub kind of back and forth. Sometimes I did it, you know, in the masses, and sometimes I did it individually. With it, I don't think I had a great rhythm to what I was doing. I was just trying to get a lot of people, a lot of minutes, and try to help along those lines.
Did they run this much zone before tonight? And if so, how important was this experience for your team to actually go against them?
Yeah, it was a, you know, 1-3-1. I thought our guys did some good things. Obviously, when you have a size advantage, when you go zone, it's going to be a little bit harder to box people out, especially when Zach can anchor down there and Travion can get, you know, close to the basket. But we haven't seen a lot of zone. And so I thought that was good, even though it was, you know, a little bit unconventional. 1-3-1, you don't see a lot of 1-3-1. You see more matchups or kind of a sliding 2-3, 3-2 type zone. This was a, you know, traditional 1-3-1. And, you know, but like I said, I thought we did a good job. I don't think you can lose sight on good shots, even though I wish we'd, you know, a couple of them, more of them would have went in. So,
what they did before tonight.
Yeah, they run a 1-3-1. That's what they do. They don't do it a lot, but we worked on it. We knew they would run it at some time during the game. They probably ran it tonight more than they've run it in the past.
Coach, let's talk about Carson. Let's talk about the legacy of Coach Katie. Both you guys, obviously, legacy of Coach Katie here. At Mackey, mm-hmm. I mean, what's it mean to you? I mean, bringing the teams in, I know it had to mean a lot to him, but for you, scheduling him in here, a Boilermaker, the
right.
Crowd was great for him before the game.
Right.
What's it like, and what's that mean to you, the legacy of Coach K?
Well, it's cool. Like, you know, it's really hard, you know, getting ready for your conference season when you have to play guarantee games. You know, you're going on the road. You know, you're playing high major schools. You're really up against it, but you're trying to improve. You're trying to get better. You're trying to beat the team, you know, period. And now to work towards that and keep your guys confident. They were a little bit shorthanded tonight. I think they had 8-9 guys in the book. So I thought they played hard. I thought they did a good job. They shot the ball well. And but, no, he was – you know, Carson's a really good guy. Carson was a good player here, won a lot of games. And anytime you can have somebody that played basketball at Purdue come back here and play, it's a special moment.
When your guys go on break like this, do you want them to stay away from basketball, or kind of how do you want them to deal with the idle time?
Right. I don't think it's smart to take 4 days and just absolutely do nothing, but you also don't want them to, you know, be playing pickup on the outdoor courts either. So I think, you know, getting somewhere and shoot just depends on who you are. I think each guy normally has a pretty good routine, and when you're someone who works on your game all the time, taking 4 days off, but it's good to kind of decompress and get away from it, kind of recalibrate a little bit. But it's also, you know, keeping that focus and understanding that. It gets really hard, like, when you have as many guys as we have and you're as deep as us. I think it's good, but it's also hard because guys, you know, you don't have everybody in your rotation that gets consistent minutes. And when that happens, you know, it's you just don't have the same feel as when you do have consistent minutes. But we'll come back on the – we'll go 26th, 27th, 28th, and then play on the 29th. So we'll have three good practices before we play again.
I know Incarnate Word made some shots tonight and all that, but have you seen any kind of difference in your team's concentration or whatever from a defensive perspective hit the last two games, especially Jaden?
Yeah. I thought we had our concentration was good against Butler in terms of what they were running. We didn't have as much time to kind of drill down on what these guys were doing with just a one-day prep going Saturday, Monday. But, I think our guards have done a good job. You know, Jaden's, you know, made more plays from a defensive standpoint. But his is more of being solid. He's done a better job of being solid. He tries to hit a lot of home runs defensively. And you got to pick your spot. Like, there's got to be blood in the water and then get aggressive. When there's not blood in the water against good players, you know, and you get over-aggressive, they're going to get you on a back door. You know, they're just going to get you being overzealous on plays. But he's done a much better job with that in time. But I think everybody has. I think our concentration has been better. I don't think we've arrived by any stretch of the imagination. But we're making some improvements there, and that's good. Sometimes how other people play can help you too. Like, it just can. And like, sometimes other people schematically do things differently, it becomes a little bit harder. And it just depends, like with our team, if you stretch us out a little bit and we're bigger, it gets a little harder for us, as you've watched. Now I can flip it and go smaller, then now we've kind of cured that, but is that the best for us? Some days I believe it is, and some days I believe it isn't. But that's what's cool about having a lot of options.
You've mentioned a bunch of times before that the thing Zach's improved the most is passing.
Yes.
Can you kind of put that into context? How much does that matter for his overall game when it's a guy who draws as much attention as he inevitably is going to draw?
Well, he's got to keep his confidence when he posts up around 5 to 8 feet, because he can make that jump hook. He's gotten away from that. And layups and dunks are good, don't get me wrong. But like, he dribbled one time in the first half and lost it when he should have just shot a 5-6 foot jump hook. But when they swarm him and they had 2-3 people around him, he got Mason a couple dives. He got Mason that three on an overload play, which was good. So just having that sense of like what's going on, like how they handle him, are they doubling him, are they tripling him, and just kind of slowing down. We spend a lot of time with those guys, and working with him and Travion on their passing and what they're doing. Travion's different because Travion sees everything. You know, sometimes Travion's seeing everything and he's got a 5-foot jump hook and he'll pass that up for a three, where like he's gonna make that 80 to 90% of the time. So Travion sometimes is a little bit too unselfish. But Zach's, like he said in his last interview after Butler, like he's learned to keep things simple. Like, those passes he made were simple passes, but they were the right passes too. So you need anything? You good? Go ahead.
So I was talking to Coach Cunningham about just the building programs, and he said he considers yourself and Coach Kennedy as mentors in a way, and the way that you guys build your program.
Right.
That you guys have. Just, what does he mean? What goes into building a program?
Yeah. Right. Well, the blueprint of what we do is from Coach Katie. And so I worked for him, and I worked for Bruce Weber at Southern Illinois. And so from a scheduling standpoint, from a recruiting standpoint, those are the two most important things. And, you know, your product is your players. And then you got to know from a scheduling standpoint what you're doing, you know, and who you're playing compared to, like, really, you know, your personnel. And kind of work towards that. But having a good program, you know, means really kind of your teams play well together. You know, you have a great academic structure, so it helps guys not just get a degree, but get an education and help them in using your scholarship and this opportunity to not have a just have a great basketball career, but use this as an opportunity to have a great life and use contacts. Just don't leave here with a piece of paper. And I think that's what Coach Katie really like instilled in us. But it all kind of starts with the adversity of what goes on. People think it's easy. Like, it's not easy. I got guys on our team that started before that aren't starting now, and that's hard. You know, now we got, like I said, we got 10 starters, but I think we got good teammates. I think we got guys that pull for each other, and we got to make sacrifices for the betterment of the team. And it really just starts, you know, with Coach Katie and his blueprint of doing the right things, you know, going to class, being on time. And so when I got to college, he said he had three rules, you know, be on time, try your best, and act right. And if you kind of think about like how life is and how these opportunities, if you just kind of follow that. Now, when I was 19, I thought that was stupid. You realize it's not stupid. It's very simple and it's very smart. Because the team that normally gets beat, they normally beat themselves. And when individuals struggle or they have problems off the court, they normally do themselves in. But if you can stay with a good group of guys and recruit them and you can help each other, and now when you face some adversity, you can really grow. And that's, you know, any team can have a good season. But if you can consistently do it and do it the right way and get your degree, you know, that's what a good program's all about. So it's nice that he says that about me, but it's really, it's all comes from Coach Katie and what he did here for 25 years. Thanks.
Thank you. Have a good Christmas.
You too. I got you guys all the same thing I got you last.